in the vast white expanse where the earth meets the sky. Here we search for adequate images of alpine sports. These lack adequate images. We observe an anomaly, the snowboarder, a peculiar offshoot of these alpine sports, hurling themselves down these sacred slopes with a brash audacity that borders on the sacrilegious. The board, less an extension of the body and more a cumbersome appendage, promises not elegance, but a crude battle against gravity. Observe the snowboarder in their element, seeking not harmony with the mountain, but rather a momentary conquest, each jump launching into the void. Each landing, a jarring reminder of nature's indifference, a fleeting grasp at obscenity, and yet beneath the surface of this exhilarating liberation lies a profound solitude. These mountains, ancient and indifferent, have witnessed the ebb and flow of countless lives. The snowboarder finds solace not in the quiet majesty of the mountain, but in this thrill of disturbance, carving not just the snow beneath their feet, but a rift in the solemnity of the alpine realm. It is a spectacle of folly and hubris, this dance with danger. The snowboarder engages in a clumsy tangle with disaster, often blurring the line between bravery and absurdity. From afar, these interlopers appear as mere specks, their vibrant attire clashing with the muted elegance of the mountain. Skiing and snowboarding offer us a rare chance to skate along the edge of our mortality and touch the infinite. And yet, in their audacious descent, there is a moment of realization. The mountain does not yield to their will, but endures, impassive and immutable. The snowboarder, in their brashness, confronts their own insignificance. In this ephemeral encounter between human and nature, in the end, it is not about conquering the mountain. In the silence of the snow, we find our own insignificance and perhaps our greatest enlightenment. The mountain remains, stoic, eternal, a silent witness to the folly of those who dare challenge its dominion.